Namaste, dear students. In the last few classes, we were discussing about measures of dispersion, isn't it? In that, we have come for the last one, that is a standard deviation. So, in the last class, we discussed about combined standard deviation, isn't it? So, combined standard deviation formula, we saw the problems also. To compute combined standard deviation, first we have to compute combined arithmetic mean. After that, we have to compute D1 and D2. Next, D1 square, D2 square. Next, we have to apply the formula. Isn't it? Next, for comparing variability of two or more series, the relative measure of standard deviation is introduced. That is actually coefficient of variation. So, relative measure of a standard deviation is actually this one. Sigma divided by x bar, only this much we can say that this is the relative measure of standard deviation. The relative measure of standard deviation expressed in terms of percentage means in 200 if we do means that is called coefficient of variation. Remember, coefficient of variation. Coefficient of variation. So, in today's class, we will discuss about coefficient of variation. So, coefficient of variation means it is sigma divided by x bar into 100. For comparing the variability of two or more series, for comparing the homogeneity, for comparing the consistency of two or more series, we use this coefficient of variation or CV. So, CV formula, remember, sigma divided by x bar into 100. One thing you have to remember, CV, if CV is more, means suppose two series are there, series 1 and series 2. First you compute CV of series 1, CV of series 2. Next, which CV is less or which coefficient of variation is less, that series is more consistent or more homogeneous. So, CV less idre variability less, CV jasti idre variability jasti, at that time consistency kadime. So, consistency CV less idre consistency jasti. So, which series has a lesser CV, that series is more consistent. So, just remember, coefficient of variation formula is this one. Remember now itself. So, for comparing homogeneity of two or more series, or comparing the variability of two or more series, or comparing the consistency of two or more series, we use this coefficient of variation. So, CV less means, if CV is less means, that series is more consistent. That series is more consistent. More consistent means, their consistency is there or homogeneity is there, variation is less there. CV less means variation is less. So, remember this much, CV less means that series is more consistent or their variability is less. So, just remember this much things. First, CV coefficient of variation formula is sigma divided by x bar into 100. This one we are expressing in terms of percentage. So, it is into 100. Next, for comparing the homogeneity, variability or consistency of two or more series, we use CV. If CV is less means that series is more consistent. Next, we will do the problems. First, I'll do 2 marks problem. 2 marks means just which and all, sigma given, x bar given, just compute CV. So, that may be asked, usually asked for 2 marks. So, first problem, if mean and standard deviation of a distribution R, if mean and standard deviation of a distribution R 20 and 5 respectively 20 and 5 respectively. Find CV. Find CV. Okay. So here see such problems. So usually everything given, we have to just write the formula, substitute the values, and we have to find the answer. Such problems usually asked as 2 marks. So here what and all given? If mean and standard deviation of a distribution, mean given, standard deviation is also given. We have to compute CV. So solution, I'll write. You can write given. Mean x bar equal to, mean is given, mean first one, which one? 20. Then standard deviation is sigma is 5. We have to find CV. So coefficient of variation, now itself you remember the formula. While doing the class you have to remember the formula at that time itself. Once it is fixed to your mind you won't forget. Sigma divided by x bar into 100. CV equal to sigma divided by x bar into 100. Sigma how much? 5. X bar 20 into 100. So 20 how many times? 25 times. 5 are 25. So 25, see this much I can write it as a percentage, because it is in 200 is there, so we are writing CV in terms of percentage. So CV equal to how much? 25 percentage. Nothing I did. So what and all given there? Just write the given things first. Next CV. CV's formula you have to remember and you have to write. After that, just substitute the values. The given answer, actually it is CV in 200 is there, so we are writing it as percentage. So it is 25%. So next we will do one more problem. Second question I will do here only. If mean and standard deviation of a set of 100 values, are 50 and 4 respectively, find the coefficient of variation. So here also same thing. Here how many observations are given? That is actually we have doing nothing with that. So the one extra information is how many observations are there, isn't it? So no need. We are not considering it. Actually 50 and 4 are enough to us. Actually mean and standard deviation. So first write what and all given. Given mean equal to, mean x bar equal to how much? 50. First one mean. Next standard deviation sigma equal to 4. Correct na? CV equal to sigma divided by x bar into 100. Sigma is 4 divided by x bar is 50 into 100. 50 one time, 50 two times, 2 fours are 8. Correct na? 8%. So 8%. This is our CV. So here also x bar and sigma are directly given. Just write the formula, substitute the values and find the answer. So CV we are expressing in terms of percentage. Okay. So in such problem, same problems, in sometimes CV may be given. CV and one of the quantity, either standard deviation or mean may be given. We have to find the other one. Such problems may be asked. So here mean and standard deviation directly given. CV we have to find, apply the formula directly. In some cases, sigma and CV given, we have to find x bar. Or in some problems, x bar and CV is given, we have to find sigma. So such problems also asked. We will do one problem. So here in two problems all sigma and x bar directly given. We have to compute CV. So next, third problem. Third one. See, if CV coefficient of variation and standard deviation of a distribution R 75% and 15 respectively, find mean. So just carefully read the question. If CV coefficient of variation and standard deviation of a distribution are given, CV given, similarly standard deviation given, we have to find the mean, correct na? So how to do? First, just write what and all given. Solution: given CV equal to, CV means CV itself, CV equal to 75, percentage is there, percentage no need to consider here, percentage, however CV is given in percentage, and 15 standard deviation is sigma equal to 15. We have to find which one, x bar equal to how much, correct na? So write the formula, CV equal to sigma by x bar into 100. CV how much? 75 equal to sigma is 15, x bar we don't know, into 100, correct na? This x bar I can take here, or else again you can simplify, 1500 divided by x bar. So x bar we have to find, this is divided by x bar, when it comes here it is into 75, x bar equal to 1500, or x bar equal to 1500 divided by 75, correct na? So x bar equal to 1500 divided by 75, nothing here, actually this is divided by, when it comes to the left it is into, so 75 x bar equal to 1500, therefore x bar equal to 1500, this is into 75, when it comes here it is divided by 75, answer is 20, so x bar equal to 20. So such problems usually asked as 2 marks problems, so be clear what and all given, you have to see first, then write the given things, next we can do, clear na? Yes. Can we go to 10 marks questions? See, remember coefficient of variation problems are very important, usually asked for 10 marks. So we will do 10 marks question, 2 series given, we have to compare the coefficient of variation, or we have to compare the variability of 2 series. So which CV is less, that series is more consistent. So we will do next problem. Okay, next question, CV problems are 10 marks. Calculate CV from the following data. Calculate CV from the following data. Following data regarding points scored by, regarding points scored by two teams, team A and team B. Find which team is more consistent. find which team is more consistent. Team A, team B. Team A, 28451. Here it is 36943. See here, read the question properly. See, such problems usually asked as 10 marks. See, actually, if you know how to compute sigma or standard deviation, how to compute x bar, these problems are very, very easy to do, and you can easily score 10 marks here. Calculate CV from the following data regarding points scored by two teams. Find which team is more consistent. Team A's points in five matches, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here team B is this much. So we have to compute coefficient of variation. So we have to compute coefficient of variation separately for team A and team B. Isn't it? So team A, first we will do team A. Solution I will write. See, first I am doing everything for team A. So team A's CV we have to find. For computing CV we require sigma and x bar. Correct na? So team A, here this is actually score or points, so points x. Next x square I am doing to compute which one, for computing standard deviation. X this one, 28451, correct na? Here team B is separate, so don't compare this one separate. Team B's we are doing later. So team A's score or points this much. So x square I computed for computing standard deviation. So x square is required. X is this one. So 2 2's are 4, 8 8's are 64, 4 4's are 16, 5 5's are 25. Here 1. Sigma x is required. 20 here. Here how much? Here it is 110. Correct na? See, next we have to find a CV. Just remember CV formula. CV equal to sigma divided by x bar into 100. Isn't it? For computing CV, we have to compute x bar first. X bar equal to sigma x divided by n. This is ungrouped data. Remember, this is ungrouped data or it is row data. So row data we are computing, f won't be there, frequency is not there. Sigma x, total x is 20, n number of observations, it is 5. So it is 4. Correct na? Next sigma. Sigma equal to square root of sigma x square divided by n minus sigma x divided by n the whole square. Correct na? So square root of sigma x square. Sigma x square means x square column total. 110. 110 divided by 5 minus sigma x by n. Sigma x by n we computed here only. It is 4. 4 square. So 110 divided by 5, you will get one answer, minus 4 4s are 16. So after subtracting, you will get one answer, its square root. Its square root is, I will write the answer only, it is 2.4. It is 2.45. Clear na? What we did? Yes. For computing CV of team A, first consider only team A. Team A's scores this much. Next we have to compute CV. For computing CV, we have to compute standard deviation. For computing standard deviation, x square column is required. So this total, first find x bar. X bar is this much, sigma. After applying the formula, we are getting the answer as 2.45. After that, what we have to do? We have to compute CV. CV of team A, that is sigma divided by x bar into 100. Sigma how much? Sigma is 2.45. x bar here we computed, it is 4 into 100. Answer is 61.25, that much a percentage. So hope this much clear to you. So once you know the CV formula, we can do. Next, what we have to do? Same, we have to compute for team B. Correct na? Team B is everything. Score and all are different here. Team B. Again, I am computing X itself. X and X square. So for identification purpose, you can do Y also. No problem. Y anta kelavariki kashta aagutade. Then next here, sigma Y square divided by N will come. At that time, some people may get confused. So I am denoting it as X only. So team B's score we have to put. How much? 36943. 36943. Next X square, same procedure we have to compute for team B, isn't it? Team B, 3 3s are 9, 36, 81, correct na? Sigma X 25, this is 151, clear na this much? Yes, next what we have to do? Yes, we have to do X bar equal to sigma X divided by N. Sigma X is 25 divided by 5. Correct na? It is 5. 25 divided by 5. Sigma equal to square root of sigma X square divided by N minus sigma X divided by N the whole square, which is sigma X square by N, 151 divided by 5 minus 5 the whole square. Sigma X by N we computed directly here. Answer is here only. So I wrote that answer here. So 151 divided by 5, you will get one answer. You have to write here minus 5 into 5, 25. This one minus this one. You have to subtract first. You will get one quantity. It's square root. See, answer I will write. Answer is 2.28. Clear na? Next what we have to do? CV of B. Coefficient of variation of B. That is sigma divided by X bar into 100. Here sigma is 2.28 divided by X bar 5 into 100. Answer is 45.61. 45.61, that much percentage. See, CV we are expressing in terms of percentage. Remember na? So we are expressing in terms of percentage. CV of first series or CV of team A, how much? CV of team A is 61.25 and CV of team B is 45.61. Which one is more consistent? See, I told earlier itself, which CV is less, that team is more consistent. Which CV less? Here 61 point, here 45 point. So, CV of B, team B is less. So, team B is more consistent. Correct na? Here variability more, here variability is less. Which variability is less, that team is more consistent. So, you have to write the conclusion. So since I'll write here, since CV of which CV less, you write that first, CV of B less than CV of A, team B is more consistent. Team B is more consistent. Team B is more consistent. Clear na? What and all we did? We have to do separately for, we have to find CV separately for team A and team B. Next, we have to compare. Okay. Hope this much is clear. This is for raw data. We will do some more problems in the next class. So, hope this much clear to you. Okay. We will continue in the next class. Thank you.